there was a certain group in my school, and they were just nuts, partying every weekend. And I had a friend who had the same circumstance as me in middle school. She wasn't popular, she was quiet, but she would do anything to fit in. She wanted in, so she did anything. She went to parties, she would get drunk, promiscuous sex. And I just saw her wither away. I would watch her lose herself the more and more she did all of that. And it scared me away from, parties. I go to safe parties, but I won't go to those wild ones because I saw everything that it did to her.
Hey, Alicia, have you ever done anything to fit in that went against your Christian morals or values?
Yeah, it's hard to admit it, but sometimes popularity just becomes so important that you do things that you later reflect on and you regret them.
Yeah, no, I think I agree with you. I think everyone here has done, you know, something that was wrong to fit in, something that we usually wouldn't do, but you just want so bad to be popular that you would go against everything you stand for. But I think that if you make amends with God, everything would be okay.
Fitting in and popularity are important to teens, and I think to humans in general.
Yeah, that's true. Everyone wants to feel loved and accepted.
But how far would you or should you go to be accepted?
To fit in, to be popular.
That is what we will be talking about today. Hi everyone, I'm Alicia.
And I'm Jonathan.
And this is Real Faith TV.
You've already met Kristen at the beginning of the show, talking about a friend who did whatever she could to fit in. We will hear more about her own experiences as a teenager fitting in, and we'll also talk with Matt about his experiences on this topic.
Our music video is called Prophet, Priest, and King by Small Town Poets.
We will also meet our studio guests and get their views on this topic. But first, let's see how important fitting in is to the teens we talk to on the street.
It was really important to me, except for this year, when I realized that I can hang out with whoever I want to hang out with, whoever I like, and that's fine for me.
Is fitting into a group important to you?
Yeah, because you want to be respected by everybody. You don't want to, like, be left out and stuff.
Yeah, it's important because I want to have friends and have everyone like me.
Sometimes it is, because I don't want to be, like, a loner or anything.
I do things that I want to do. I don't do things just because other people want me to.
I'm, like, my own person, so, you know, I don't, you know, follow what other... I'm a leader, I'm not a follower.
I mean, I want to be an individual, but I wouldn't want to be left out of things, so.
I used to not fit into any group, so... Once I found a group of friends that do have the same, like, ideas I have and feelings about other people, then usually I get along.
I wanted to be, like, one of the popular cool kids, but when I found out who my true friends were, they're all from different groups, so it doesn't really matter anymore.
I mean, fitting is not really important to me, and I don't think I'll ever do anything to just fit into one specific group.
I've never fit in, so I've never tried. It's never really mattered to me. I kind of like to do my own thing.
I try to not fit in, actually. Try and stand out as an individual. Try to be a little bit different than everybody else. I got the fancy shoes going.
I agree with the one girl who said that she doesn't care what anyone thinks about her. She's going to be her leader, not a follower.
Yeah, she had a good point. I also think it does feel nice to be part of a group at sometimes, though.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what our studio guests think about this. Today we have with us Martin, Meredith, Sarah, Ross, Powell, and Vanessa.
So what do you guys think about popularity and fitting in? Is it important to you?
Well, I think that in middle school it was a lot more important, but then once you get older, you develop your personality more and it doesn't really matter to you anymore.
I don't know. I still think popularity is important to most teenagers, you know, our age. And even if it's not number one on their list, it's, you know, top five, top 10 probably.
Yeah, but as you grow up, you realize that, you know, people don't accept you for, you know, if you go along with a group, they accept you for who you are. And, you know, they respect you more if you do something with your life. And that's how you gain popularity when you grow up.
Especially, you'll make your best friends when you're not trying to be somebody else. Like, when you're really yourself, and you're not trying to be popular, not trying to be fit in, when you're yourself, that's when you make the friends that you keep for the rest of your lives, because you know that they really like you for who you are. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, I think that's a good point. We can define popularity as a lot of things. For some people, it could be being the prom king or the prom queen. But for other people, it could just be finding a group of people that accepts them for exactly who they are and is always there for them. Because it is a good feeling if you walk into a room and you know someone that accepts you, someone you can talk to if you had a bad day, walk into the lunchroom and you see someone you know, or you're walking in the halls with someone, that makes you feel good about yourself. But if you got that by being yourself, it's even better.
Yep. And also, if you put on that mask, you won't have as much fun. And even if it's the people you want to be friends with, you're not going to have fun with them if you're going to be acting like someone you're not.
Yeah. And if you put the mask on and, you know, you try to be someone that you're not, you might even forget who you really are inside, you know, and it might cause a lot of internal struggle.
I think it's really important, like, people think it's really important to try to be popular before you find your special group of friends. And then once you find them, you realize that all those years that you've been doing these weird things, like trying to be popular, you really didn't have to do that because you finally found where you wanted to be.
Yeah, I mean, popularity doesn't guarantee happiness.
Exactly.
Exactly. There's a lot of different kinds of popularity, too. There's good popularity and bad popularity. Like, I might do something at a party to fit in, and I might fit in with a bad crowd of people that'll go and tell people, oh, Alicia did this, you know, something that could be against my morals or even against the law. On the other hand, I could be popular for good reasons. I could be a really good friend, or I could be funny or nice, or just people are drawn to me because I accept other people for who they are. So in that case, I think that's good. Mm-hmm. If you're trying to be popular, as in someone that's well-liked and someone that people know they can rely on to be themselves.
How far would you go to fit in? That's what we asked our teens in the next segment.
Let's see what they said.
Have you ever done something wrong, like, to try to fit in?
Yeah, probably. My friends probably dared me or told me to drink something, and I probably did, just so I could have friends and be liked.
I know I've done things like make my parents buy me clothes, and, you know, I've yelled at them, like, you don't give me a car or something like that.
Like, made fun of people that I actually liked and were friendly to just because the rest of the people were.
Actually, I have. Like, I lost a good friend just to be friends with somebody else, and it really wasn't worth it.
I went to an extreme length one time, and it got me into a lot of trouble. And I mean, I learned my lesson, especially because the person doesn't even like talk to me anymore.
A bunch of friends wanted to do something to kind of initiate a group, and I did it, and I was in the group, and that was kind of a bad thing to do, but.
What did you learn from that? Was it worth it in the end?
No, in the end it wasn't worth it because I ended up getting in trouble for it, so.
I think that one time or another, we have all been guilty of doing something we normally wouldn't do to fit in.
What about you guys? Have you ever done anything to fit in?
Well, I think a lot of people have, you know, tried to buy popular clothes or like the clothes that all the cool kids were wearing and just try to fit in that way. I mean, it doesn't have to be anything major.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, certain brands.
Just mm-hmm. ignoring people, trying to stay away from people that you love, but you don't want to be around them because maybe they're not the popular people. Mm-hmm. Just simple stuff like that.
It's a good point. Maybe somebody that's not as popular comes up to you, kind of reaching out because they don't have so many friends, they want to sit with you or something, and you say no because you know it'll tarnish your own reputation if you have this person sit next to you. But then you have to think about, that's not something Jesus would do. He would do the thing that would accept people for who they are, and he would never deny who he was. I mean, he did something very unpopular when he said, you know, I'm the Son of God. Everybody said, no, you know, you're not. And it was unpopular with a lot of people, but he found people who believed him and who accepted him for who he was.
Sarah had something to say. I saw her.
Yeah, starting. Some people, like, when they actually sit or, like, are with the people that they really wanted to be with for a long time, they'll do anything to fit in more. And sometimes when you make fun of people that you really like, but you make fun of them anyway because you're finally in that group. And also, like, I remember I buy, like, CDs and stuff that I really don't like, but my group likes them, so I just go along with that.
So do you guys think it was worth it, like, all the stuff you did to fit in?
In the end, it's never really worth it.
Mm-hmm. I don't think it's worth it.
No?
No, it seems stupid.
Whatever acceptance it gains you isn't true acceptance anyway. It's for something that you wouldn't normally do if you were in your
it's
own
fake.
Character.
Yeah.
There are many pressures on us today to fit into certain groups or categories. Life is competitive, and most people want to keep up.
But often we are asked or pressured into doing things that we normally wouldn't do, or would not like to do just to fit in or be considered popular.
In our next segment, Matthew and Kristen share their ideas on fitting in and popularity.
Yes, I think it is important to me, fitting into a group, because
you always want someone to be there for you and someone you can share your interests with.
It's not number one on my list, but I want to be liked and I want to be wanted and appreciated.
I would like to say I wouldn't go like too far beyond who I really am to fit in, because then every time I hang out with that group, I'd have to go and like be someone I wasn't, like basically act out some different personality that I wouldn't really want to have to go too far to do.
Not too far. I won't do stuff that's wrong or immoral. I won't do stuff just to impress people. I do stuff because it's good for me.
There were a couple kids who were on like my soccer team and things like that who I wanted to like me, and I wanted to be able to, you know, talk to them and stuff. So I'd kind of let them copy my homework, or, you know, they'd be doing something wrong and I wouldn't go tell someone, be like, oh, you know, they're cheating or doing something illegal.
Was it worth it?
No, it definitely was not worth it, because even after I did it, they'd be like, oh, thanks for that, and then the next day, totally ignore me, wouldn't talk to me, none of that.
What happens to people who don't fit into a group?
Well, I remember in grammar school, we had like 30 kids in the class, so if you didn't fit in, I mean, there was absolutely nobody to hang out with, because I come from a small town. So if you didn't fit into the group, you basically were like hanging out with yourself for like 8-9 years. But in high school, it's kind of different, because if you don't fit into one group, you can always go find another group.
Fitting in our teenage years is really important to us, because our friends give us something that they teach us about stuff that we can't give ourselves.
So you think it's important to fit in?
It's important to find real, true friends.
Well, I'd say it's pretty important, especially with people who don't have close families or a lot of siblings, because they need that someone to talk to. And if their parents are gone all day and they don't have any brothers or sisters, they get kind of lonely. So I think, especially those children, they'll go that extra distance to have those friends to hang out with and be with, because they need someone to talk to.
I've seen teens, just to fit in, they lost their virginity, they did drugs, they said stuff, they turned their back on friends. And I really think it's sad.
Did it work out for them?
They found untrue friends. They got in the wrong crowd. It wasn't worth it.
Be yourself. I mean, you hear it, but if you actually think about it, it helps out a lot, because once you start trying to be someone else, it gets that much harder every time you hang out with that group to be someone different, because you have to constantly act a different personality, be someone different. And then you start hanging out with kids that you normally didn't want to hang out with. And then you find out halfway down the road that it was the wrong decision, because you wanted to hang out with them, and now they're leading you on the wrong path.
I really agreed with both of the things that they said, that stay on the right path to who you are. You can't alter your actions, go against your morals and what you believe, just to do something to please a certain group of people, because those people will turn out not to really be your friends anyway, and then you've really just, you know, discredited yourself, you've discredited God, and you've really turned away from Him, and that you haven't accepted who you are, and you haven't accepted that you can find comfort in Him when other people might not accept who you truly are.
Yeah, I think that you should never change for anybody. Just be yourself, you know? And if you only have one friend when you're yourself, hey, that's gonna be your best friend of your life, you know? You could be popular and have two friends. As long as you're happy, and as long as you realize that, you know what, I'm not gonna change myself, I'm not gonna lower myself so I can hang out with kids that are cool or popular because they do whatever. And did you guys ever have to make a hard choice that made you unpopular?
I was never popular. Like Matt said, I went to a small school, so there was like 50 kids in our whole grade, and there was only a few people that weren't popular, and I was one of them. Mm-hmm. But it never really bothered me, because like I played sports, so I was friends with people there, but I never liked what they would do. Like, they would talk behind people's backs and, you know, spread rumors and stuff. So I just, like, I never really had any friends in school, and if I did have them, they were on the outside with me. But like, I was really fine with it at the time, because I didn't agree with what they were doing.
But did you have like any like really good friends, like one or two maybe, that helped you get through it?
Actually, I did, but like, I would have a great friend one year, and then the next year they would all of a sudden be popular and like change. So it was kind of like a different person every year, but
at least you had somebody.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else?
I know I've been in the same situation as Matt a lot, where people have asked me to copy off of my homework or whatever, even if it's a simple problem, I know if I give this answer to this person, they're gonna be nice to me, they're gonna talk to me in the hallways, and I'm gonna seem popular, then I think, you know, that's wrong. I would be going against myself because I wouldn't be taking credit for my own work, and I'd be doing something that I know is wrong.
Yeah, I think a lot of people have been in that kind of situation, can be at different degrees. For example, one time I was in a room and no one was there, and it was just me and a few friends, and they started smoking, and I wasn't offered or anything, but I knew that they kind of...
They wanted you.
Yeah, they wanted me to do that, and like just to be cool or whatever, because they felt grown up, but I just didn't say anything and I walked away.
Good for you. Okay. I think that, once again, you should never change. Be yourself, stick to your guns.
If our self-worth is wrapped up in what others think of us, we will always be disappointed and hurt.
If all our energy is going into gaining acceptance by others, we will always be seeking to please other people instead of doing what makes us happy.
If our identity is rooted in God's love for us, then we will always be accepting of ourselves without having to pretend we're something we aren't.
We will be able to love ourselves and work on what will make us truly happy rather than on empty things. God loves us no matter what.
That is what Matt and Kristen have found out. In our next segment, they talk about what when they feel alone and outcast and how their faith has gotten them through.
Faith helps me because when I don't have friends to talk to and I'm having problems and I can't talk to a certain group or my friends, I know I can always turn to God. You know, I'll go home, I'll pray, talk to God about my problems, because I know God will help me out whenever I need it. So that helps from that point of view. And then it also helps because I'll find a group that has a strong faith and good morals, and I can hang out with them. And then they can help me like strengthen my faith, because we'll talk about, you know, morals and what we believe in and what we believe is right and wrong. And then it makes me feel that much better and feel like I can go out and do good things, and those people are going to back me up.
My faith has helped me to remain true to myself. It's helped me remain strong. Makes me feel like I'll be okay even if I go through tough times, if people turn their back on me, if I feel alone. God never leaves you alone.
Have you ever been outcast, not fit in somewhere?
Yes, I believe I have not fit in, yeah.
And what did that feel like?
It didn't feel too good because I liked some of the kids who like I was basically outcasted from, and I wanted to hang out with them. But, you know, they didn't really want to hang out with me, so that wasn't a great feeling. But I eventually found another group to hang out with.
When I was in middle school, I wasn't popular. So my faith helped me because at my bus stop, I would actually silently pray. And that helped me. I just prayed to God that my angel would be by my side and that I wouldn't cry.
And God will always help you find the right friends, especially if you talk to him. Pray to him that you will make the right decisions and pick the right friends, and he will help you, because God will never turn away from any of his children.
I think it was really great what they both said, especially Kristen about the angels by her side and she feels lonely. It's great that she can recognize the strength in herself and the strength that she finds in God whenever she feels like she's not accepted.
Yeah, and I like what Matt said when he was like, God will always lead you to find the group of people that you're supposed to be with. Now I have a question for you guys. Have any of you been in a similar situation like Matt and Kristen where you like didn't fit in, and what helped you through it?
Definitely my faith helped me through it, because I realized that even though a part of me wanted to be popular, I realized that I didn't want to be like them because I didn't agree with what they were doing. And then when I was old enough to be in youth group, that's where I found my true friends. Like now, mm-hmm. All my best friends are through youth group, because that is a place where they have the same values and the same beliefs that you do, and that you can really talk about anything, and that you know that they'll be there for you when you need them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. As we grow up, it's easier to make new friends, because we go from middle school, where we're pretty much all from the same grade, we've gone to school together forever, and then we go to high school, and there's all these different people that you can choose from, find the people that have the same interests as you. And then pretty soon, since our lives are changing so much, we get to go to college, we get to do it all over again, find the same people with the same values, get to know them, and then we get into the real world, and by that time we've kind of cemented who we are, and we don't really need to feel like we need to do other things to make ourselves popular with other people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you know, does faith or God like play any role in like who you hang out with still?
Yeah, I would say that like people's morals, I mean, when I look for friends or whatever, I look at people's morals. If they
if they have no sense of value, or if they, you know, that's not the kind of people that I like to be around.
I used to, go ahead.
That's a huge part for me about morals, you know, like, there's, like, if I'm sitting in class and I hear people, like, gossiping or talking about, like, what they were doing over the weekend, I don't know if I'd turn around and, like, and be involved in the conversation, and that's really a big part of how I choose my friends.
Okay. You want a friend that's going to treat you well.
Exactly.
And somebody that's going to treat you well is somebody that follows the values of Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Let's check out our video today, Prophet, Priest, and King by Small Town Poets.
All right, let's check it out.
Down my thoughts in a letter to the president. Penciled and packaged with all due respect. Elvis commemoratives just for effect. Never look back, think you know a guy. My congrats to Chuck and Di some time ago.
All my love to the queen.
My invitation was lost in the mail, but I knew I was missed when they kissed neath the veil. I sent a nice gift, never got a note. But my clothes tried to an old friend of mine. Here I talk all the time with a prophet and priest. But our boxes and brooms, I gush like a broom. For it's here I can do with a prophet, priest, and king.
Prophet, priest, and king.
Prophet, priest, and king.
Prophet, priest, and king.
Some heads of state. Cause I talk to a prophet who tells me the truth. And I dine with a king at my home in Duluth. Better yet, I'm in touch with a much needed friend.
That was a pretty cool video, and it had a really good message because there's this guy, and he's, you know, writing cards to Princess Di and all these people, these popular icons in the world, and he's saying that he put all this effort into doing this, and, you know, he didn't receive their invitation to the wedding, but of course we know that he didn't get one. He's just kind of kidding himself, but then he recognizes that he always has this great friend who's a prophet, priest, and king. We all know that that's Jesus, and that that's this great friend that he has that will be more important and more beneficial to him than any pop icon could ever be.
Yeah. The video is pretty cool because, you know, you see the guy sending all these cards to all these famous people. He's putting all the effort in and nothing's coming back. You know, like he says, oh, they never wrote back. I sent them a gift, no thank you card came. But yet, the prophet, the priest, and the king was there. Jesus was there for him, and he didn't do anything for him. He'll always be there for you. I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah. Definitely, because, I mean, faith is always there for you, and it's like popularity has its ups and its downs, and faith is always steady, and it's always there, and you just, popularity isn't, because it's like you'll have it one second, and the next, it'll
right.
be gone.
Yeah. Well, like Alicia and John said, you know, he's trying to justify why he didn't get an invitation, you know, oh, it got lost in the mail, yeah, all this other stuff. And then he realizes, you know, I sent him a present, they never sent me a card or thank you. And he's like, but I always had this great friend who's the prophet, priest, and a king. And like towards the end of the video, he finally realizes, you know, he's more important to me than anybody could ever be.
Yeah.
You just have to remember that faith is more important than popularity. You have to have faith in yourself, that you can make friends for the person that you are. And you have to have faith in God that His will be that you find friends that are good and matching to you. They have the same values as you. You don't have to do anything that you know is wrong to fit in with them.
I think we underestimate how much of a friend Jesus sees that we are. Like, you know, he thinks that we're his best friends. And sometimes, you know, I bet all of us here go, you know, you get kind of detached from Jesus. You're like, you know, you think of him as someone that's holy and divine, but he's really like a person just like us. He could be your best friend. He could be someone you can go and talk to. You know what I mean?
You won't have to worry about all like the pressures of like not being yourself or something when you're talking with Jesus.
He knows who you are already.
Exactly. He's like the perfect friend.
And faith is very important too, because if you are like a loner or you're not one of those people that wear the mask, then you always know that you always have Jesus as a friend. And when you are having bad days and stuff, He's always there. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to do that popularity thing.
Yeah, it's true.
Exactly. You might be sitting by yourself at lunch, but you always have Jesus to talk to. And then when you are sitting with someone else, you can remember how Jesus would treat his friend. He would be himself, and he would treat them with respect. And that's what you should look for when you look for a crowd, not just popularity. Mm. If people don't like you for who you are, their friendship is not worth your energy.
That's right. God gave everyone personalities that make us special and unique.
Anyone who tries to take this away from another person is offending the creativity of God.
Is fitting in important to you? We want to know. Contact us through our website.
Post your thoughts on our message boards or drop us an email. Our address is realfaithtv.com.
If you're not connected to the internet, you can call us at area code 609-406-7402.
And think about this. What could be more cool than being popular with the only perfect being on earth?
If you're popular with God and fit in with His family, your acceptance is unconditional.
Your needs will always be met, and what others think won't matter.
Thanks for joining us today.
We will see you next time
on Real Faith TV. God bless.